As humans, it's our inherited beliefs, customs, and artistic expressions that make up our identity. This is what we call culture. But can culture exist in other animal species like killer whales? Meet Lance.
I'm director of the Marine Mammal Research Program at OceanWise.
Lance and his team have made some very interesting discoveries about killer whale culture.
This is really unusual in animals. In fact, it's the thing that got me excited as a young, sort of budding, beginning researcher.
Here are five behaviors that illustrate how killer whales are another species with culture. Language. Killer whale clans share a common ancestor and use similar calls or dialects.
All these killer whale matrilines have the distinct dialect. And females are definitely choosing males that have a very different dialect from their own. This is a pretty cool way to avoid inbreeding in a small population.
Food. Killer whale populations can live in the same bodies of water, but have entirely different dietary preferences.
There's no reason to think that biologically a resident killer whale isn't capable of eating a seal, or a seal-eating big killer whale isn't capable of eating a fish. These are things that they've learned.
Mothers. Individual killer whales stay with their mothers for life.
As a killer whale, you know who your family is, what distinguishes it? Well, your mom. Sons and daughters, even as they grow into adults, stay with her for life.
Killer whales within a family group, or matriline, share their food, support each other when injured, and in sad cases, they can be seen mourning the loss of a calf.
And in those cases, she'll often carry it around for hours or days, and it's a really sad thing to see. It's heartbreaking, in fact, and when you see that, you can't, there's no words, there's no way to understand that, except that there's this strong love, affection, whatever you want to call it, but this very strong bond, social bond between her and her calf.
Traditions. Cultural groups even have their own traditions. For example, northern resident killer whales engage in something called beach rubbing.
They'll take turns swimming along the shoreline, scraping on these stones in 2 or 3 feet of water, rolling around as they go. Yes, don't you wish you had a bed full of these stones?
Parties. Yes, you heard that correctly. Killer whales like to party.
So they're kind of social parties, they're sex parties, they're you name it.
Once a year, multiple clans join together for a few hours or days and form super pods.
Everybody's squealing their head off. They join up. There's lots of breaching and pushing and shoving and jumping and, you know, a lot of excitement. And in the case of northern residents, during one of these super pod parties, they'll stop and beach rub right in the middle of it all. So, go to the beach, have a rub, come back. Everybody gets tired, they hang out with their moms for a little bit, and then that can continue for a period of time.
Understanding killer whale culture is really interesting, but why is it important for us to know?
Understanding the role of culture helps us understand what we're trying to conserve. We don't have to just have a bunch of killer whales that are alive at the end of the day. We have to have intact family groups. We have to preserve killer whale clans. We have to preserve the conditions that make it possible for mothers and their offspring to stay together through time. Without that kind of cultural learning that takes place, we can't imagine that kind of hierarchy, that distinct social organization lasting.